What is going on, everybody? Sam here. I hope you've had a good day. I hope your week has been great. I hope everything that you're trying to do is working out. Because when you master yourself, you can master the things that happen around you. Last week, I started something with you. This idea of what it means to master yourself. Self-mastery is not about being better than someone else. It's not about selfishly reflecting on who you are for your own benefit. No, mastering yourself is about becoming a better person to be a better person to other people. Be better to yourself so you can be better to someone else. 5 ideas I want to share with you over the next couple of videos. Today, I want to talk about the first thing. The first step or the first stage in mastering yourself is figuring yourself out. Figuring yourself out. What does that mean? The key to self-mastery is self-knowledge. How much of yourself are you in touch with? How much of yourself do you know? Are you aware of the areas of your life that need work, the areas that are working? Self-knowledge gives you the confidence to improve, the confidence to adjust and to make the necessary changes. So here's this idea that I want you to also grasp, that self-mastery or figuring yourself out, it's not about physical features only. It's not about how you look. Listen to this. You never know yourself till you know more than your body, said poet Thomas Traherne. You never truly know yourself until you know more than your body. For a lot of you, you know what you look like. You know your height, you know your weight, you know what kind of clothes look good on you, you know what kind of shoes look good on you. You know what accessories to place on yourself, but you don't really know yourself inside. I'm talking about mastering yourself by figuring out, who am I really? Who am I really? When people look at me and they ask me, who are you? Do I just know my name, or do I really know myself as a person? But let's be honest, it's hard to deal with what you really are. It's one thing to find out the areas that need work, but it's another to really deal with them. Listen to what Mae Sutton says. We have to dare to be ourselves, however frightening or strange that self may prove to be. It is scary to dig beneath the surface. It is very intimidating to go below the waves and really work on who you are as a person. See, there are things that you may not ever know about yourself. There are things that other people will reveal to you, but then there are things you can really get in touch with and figure them out. This is not some psychology babble. This is the reality of life. If you don't know yourself, how are you going to truly know other people? What is it that you need to figure out? Figure out your strengths. Know what your strengths are. Know what your abilities are. Know what it is that you come with, that you can work with and improve on. Also, know your weaknesses. Because if you don't know your weaknesses, they say a chain is as strong as its weakest link. If there's an area of your life that's not working out, that can topple everything else like a bunch of dominoes. Know your capacity, know your limits. I love basketball. I love playing basketball, but my height may never allow me to play in the NBA. As much as I love the sport, know your capacity. Operate in the areas where your strengths lie and improve what needs to be done. And most of all, know your gifts and your talents and operate within them. The people who identify their gifts, know their talents, these are the people who experience self-mastery and contribute the most in the world around them. Lamentations chapter 3 and verse 40, the Bible says, instead, let us test and examine our ways. Let us turn back to the Lord. You must do self-evaluation. Figure yourself out. Even the text says, is your behavior in line with God's will? Is your life aligned with what you're supposed to be and what you're supposed to be doing? So the very first step to self-mastery is figuring yourself out. Is it easy? No, it's not. Does it profit you to do that? Yes, it does. So until the next session, I pray that you begin to work on who you truly are. And remember, invite God into the process, and He will activate some amazing things in your life as you try to figure out who you are. Until next video, God bless you, and I'll see you.